Welcome to another exciting session. This is our third series on supporting business to move into the digital technology space. And today we are focusing on business process automation. Our guest speaker is Frida Owinga, the founder of Passion Profit. This is a people and business development organization that elevates the human experience from surviving to thriving, backed by scientific data on the conditions of how human beings live, work, and thrive using tried and tested techniques and tools. So at this point in time, I welcome Frida Owinga to share with us about business process automation. Welcome, Frida.
It's a pleasure to be here with you this morning, and I'll be sharing with you on business process automation. So as you've heard, I run a company called Passion Profit. That is the company dear to me, and I help people turn their passion into profit so that they can live, work, and thrive. And this morning, I'm going to be sharing with you seven items. Number one, of course, the definition of business process automation so that we can be aligned. I'm not a techie. I'm a people and business development professional. So we need an alignment of what it means. There are fantastic techies in the house that are going to be sharing with you at the end some resources they have to help you. And so we'll go through the definition. What are some benefits? There are many, many benefits. I just have some. What do you need to automate? In my opinion, there are many more, I'm sure. I'll share with you a quick start guide that we have used successfully at Passion Profit and with some of our clients. Then I'll share a little bit about how to balance your team. And then I'll share a sample systems directory. And at the end, we're going to look at resources. I'll give you a small directory of resources. And we have three fantastic speakers who will share for you what they're doing right here in Kenya. We have Open World, we have StockUp, and we have Twiva. And as we carry on here, the first thing, of course, we're going to look at what is the definition. I got this definition from Gartner Glossary. It says business process automation is the use of technology to automate processes throughout an organization. Processes are defined as activities that are designed to accomplish specific goals. Examples include procuring goods, approving contracts, and onboarding new hires. My favorite automation is my calendar. I have a calendar, an automated calendar. If somebody wants to meet me, I send you a link and you find the appropriate time for you. Because I found I was wasting a lot of time trying to align with people's schedules when they want to meet me. So there's this tool calendar, it is out there. This cool calendar is out there, it's free, it's called Calendly. And there are many others. And you can set the time when you want to meet people. So you're not meeting people all the time and wasting your time. Not really wasting your time, but putting your time in things that are not your core. So that way the slots that you go and find that are empty, if it aligns with your time, it sends you a link. It sends you the Zoom link and the time, and it reminds you when to meet me. And that is a fantastic automation that has reduced my budget for having a PA. I do have a virtual assistant, but she has one less thing to do. McKinsey says that according to McKinsey, 45% of work activities can be automated using technology. Can you imagine that 45%? 83% of decision makers believe workflow automation is essential to digital transformation. These are just some statistics to set us on the same page for this morning. The same study asked the question, are you currently using artificial intelligence in your process automation efforts? 25% said yes, 53% said not yet, 22% said no. So you can see that a number of people still need to join the automation process. And still on some statistics here, McKinsey says 31% of businesses are fully automated at least one function. I'm in that 31% because I've automated my calendar, but there are a couple other things I've automated. I'll share as we go along if it is relevant. There's lots of benefits for automation. Number one, improved employee morale. People don't like doing repetitive tasks. So if they're able to focus on their core and automate what is repetitive, it does improve their morale. It improves productivity because of the use of meeting tools like Zoom, Google Meet, and others. We are able to not sit in traffic waiting for each other. You can have a meet. I have many meetings when I'm traveling. And when I'm traveling simply from my house to a meeting or something, I choose those hours to have meetings because I can have a Zoom call as I'm going, as opposed to sitting somewhere using my time to do something that is not productive. And then reliability because the data doesn't lie, and also consistency. Machines don't forget if you set them. If I don't have the calendar, somebody needs to remind me. Can you imagine what a chore to remind somebody all the time about their calendar? And that's what we used to do before. Personal assistants needed to do that, but now the machine can help us. Non-invasive technology. These are just some benefits of having automation, and you can look through them. Compliance. Compliance helps you to be on the right side. I like when it comes to compliance, we know that we need to pay our care, our VAT, we need to do our VAT returns by the 20th. So our accountant has set up a calendar. Every 10th of the month, I receive an email reminding me that I should send the documents that he needs to do the VAT so that it's not forgotten. Before that, I used to write the date 19th and I start shaking. Have we done our VAT returns? All right. So it can help you be compliant also. Low technical barrier because you don't have to spend a lot of money in infrastructure. And then it also enhances accuracy in what you do. There's less human error. Okay. So that's that about the benefits. And this is just giving you some very basic tips on how to get started. I'm calling it a quick start guide to business process automation. Bill Gates says the first rule of any technology used in a business is that automation applied to efficient operation will magnify the efficiency. The second rule is that automation applied to an inefficient operation will magnify the inefficiency. So first you need to get efficient manually and then automate. If you automate inefficiency, you continue being inefficient. So there is no magic. The machines are made for the human for the machines. So sometimes people think if we automate, we won't need the people. Automation just means that people will need to learn different skills. Jobs are not going away, jobs are evolving. So when you hear machines are taking away our jobs, let people know machines are taking away mundane tasks and allowing us to use our brain to be more innovative and creative. But the first thing is you need to be efficient, and I'm going to share some tips with you on how to do that. You need to have systems running well before you automate. So what are some things that you can automate? Repetitive activities, like what I've just shared, your KRA returns, doing any other kind of return, calendar, scheduling meetings, scheduling returns, scheduling when you're supposed to do one thing or another, newsletter, social media, all the stuff that you do in your company. And that's why every company needs to audit their systems. What are the things that you do that are repeatable, that are repetitive? What are the things that you do that are scalable? What are the things that you do that are predictive? Of course, the things that are predictive, KRA returns is a common one. When do you do performance evaluation? In our company, we have a tool called the Best Year Yet that helps us to do performance evaluation with the people that we coach and also with the team. With the people that we coach, we meet once a month. So, and by the time we meet once a month, you'll have entered what you did the last month, what you're going to do the next month. You look at your score and you're able to see how you're doing. So these are some areas that you can automate. I'm not going in deeply because we are all from different organizations, from different sectors, but I'm giving you a high level overview so that you can be able to start in a structured manner. So this is my quick start guide for automation. Number one, analyze your time, your tasks, and your team, all right? And analyzing your time will require you to do a time audit. And a time audit is taking an Excel sheet or your notebook or whatever it is that you like to track everything you do every day. Do not track your tasks. Because when I give clients this task, they track their tasks. Track your time. So from the time you wake up to the time you go to sleep, what takes your time? All right. So you'll say 6 to 6:30, devotion, shower, what, so that at the end of the 30 days, you can do this for at least 2 weeks or 30 days. Do it honestly. Don't judge yourself, because the more honestly you do it, you and your team, then you are able to clearly see the tasks that are repetitive that need to be merged. You are clearly able to see the tasks that you are engaging in that need to be transferred to another team member, the tasks that you're engaging in that need to be automated. So there is no magic. The first thing, just like, you know, when somebody wants to give you money, they want to see your audited accounts. You must know where are you and where do you want to get to, so that you can get the proper roadmap. So number one, analyze your time, your tasks, and your team. So everybody to do a time audit. And then after that, you declare what I call your queen bee role. There's only one thing a queen bee does. For those that work with honey and bees, a queen bee's role is to lay eggs, all right? So in a company, when you do something good, I say you've laid a really good egg, all right? A queen bee's role is to lay eggs. So when you do your time, when you analyze your time, you're going to discover what is your queen bee role and what are the tasks that you're engaging in that need to be transferred to another team member. You'll also realize what is a team member doing that needs to be transferred to another, or what needs to be trashed. So you need to understand what is everyone's role, what is their responsibility, what are the results that are required from them. Because the role and responsibility and the results they produce should determine the rewards that they get. So you are not paid for showing up, you are paid for delivering results. And now when you work with corporate, you hear about targets, targets, targets. And even us as SMEs, we can set up targets for our teams. So declare your queen bee role as the founder, because many times even as founders, we are running helter-skelter. Many people say running like a headless chicken, but we are not headless chickens. We are sound SMEs. So position your company to serve your queen bee role. Your company needs to have a niche. And I know in Kenya, we are parallel entrepreneurs. So you can find one person has a, like my company, I do learning solutions. I normally say that I do one thing in many spaces. That's why when James was reading my bio, you hear I'm vice chair at KEPSA, I'm president at Always, I do multiple things, but in all those spaces, I do one thing. I design and deliver learning solutions for those organizations to thrive. So as an organization, what is your queen bee role? As Passion Profit, our queen bee role is to design and deliver learning solutions that shift paradigms. So everything we're doing, everybody on the team knows that that is where your energy should be. If you are brought on board, you are brought on board to add value to that supply chain. So what about your company? To automate, you'll need to know so that you don't confuse the machine. I'm gonna stop there. Number four, once you've analyzed your time, your tasks, and the time and tasks of your team, you declare your queen bee role, the one thing that you must do. For instance, I design and deliver learning solutions. I prefer to design. I'd rather have other people delivering. I love to speak, but we have different associate trainers that we work with. There are topics I enjoy, like this topic I enjoy because this is my background, organizational leadership and management. So I enjoy this topic, so I show up. If it is a topic on accounting, somebody else will show up, all right? So once you've analyzed your time, declared your queen bee role, the one, your core and your company's core, then capture the systems and apply what I call the 3T method. The 3T method is simple. It's once you have seen the different things that you're doing, what needs to be trimmed, and then transfer. There are things that you do that you don't have to do. You can transfer them. For instance, I love social media. And if you follow me, especially on LinkedIn, you will find I post a lot of things. I love social media, but I also realize I'm not the best person to be posting on our social media all the time. So we have a virtual assistant who does our social media. And so she posts on Buffer. Buffer is the tool that we use. She sends the content calendar for the month. I approve it. And then she can post whenever she wants. Then I'll just post random things that are going on in my day and in the places that I serve. So what do you need to do? Stays on your task list. What needs to be trimmed? what needs to be done by somebody else can be transferred. All right. I'm giving you a quick guide before you start your process automation. And then what are the things that don't need to be done? They're not adding value to you. They're not adding value to your organization. Those need to be trashed. All right. This is a whole workshop that we do. It's a full day workshop. But because we're having a webinar, an introduction webinar here, I said, let me give you content that you can apply immediately. So after you've captured the systems, capturing the systems is doing that time audit where you're listing down every day what you do, what your team does. Then you begin to see what are the repetitive tasks, what are the scalable tasks, what are the predictive tasks. Then you automate them. What are the best tools to use to automate them? And then finally, balance your team. Remember, I said everybody needs to do a time audit. Everybody needs to do a task audit so that we see everyone's queen bee role. The one thing, everyone's role, responsibility, what are the results that they're bringing to the organization? So we hold each other accountable. Even you, Mr. and Mrs. Founder, you need to be held accountable. That's why we have SME Founders Association, where peers hold each other accountable for delivering results. As a founder, if you don't have somebody holding you accountable, then you can go amok doing what you want when you want because you are your own boss. But that's a story for another day. Let's move on to balancing your team. When it comes to balancing your team, I use very simple tools. This is an Excel sheet, all right? And in the Excel sheet, you want to put how many columns? 5 columns. What is the job task? For instance, virtual assistant, accountant, whatever the job task is, which trait do they excel at? When you do this job trait analysis, do it immediately after the time and task audit so that it is very clear what somebody enjoys doing and where they are spending their time. I think as small business owners, we have a good opportunity to employ people in roles and give them responsibilities to do things they love and enjoy, as opposed to corporate where you go and find people doing work they don't like. There's all this toxic. We are smaller, we are more nimble. I think we can do better. All right. So what are the Excel traits? What are the traits they excel in? And then importance of their job. What is their queen bee role? All right. Like my virtual assistant's queen bee role is to ensure I get to the meetings that I need to get to, help me not to go to places I don't need to be going to. So she knows how to manage my email. She knows my time. All right. So the importance, so once you have the task, what are the traits, then you cue the importance. Is it high importance, medium importance, or low importance? This is work that needs to be done before automation, because Bill Gates said that if you automate inefficiency, you'll just get more inefficiency. And then currently, who is the person serving on that job? Are they the best person? If they're not the best person, who should be the best person? We did this in one of the organizations I serve at the end of last year. And this year we have aligned some of our teams. There's some work that has been trashed, some work has been transferred, some work has been trimmed. And this is extremely critical, especially if you run a volunteer organization. So you don't have a fat organization with people not engaged. People not engaged is trouble. Just like they say, and what do they say about an idle mind is the devil's workshop. An idle person can create unnecessary trouble. So it's important to get people engaged. And I said again, as small business owners, we have the opportunity to engage people in things that they love and enjoy so that we have environments that people love to work in. This is a business process automation with Frida Owinga by Ajira and Kepsa. And we're looking at business process automation. I'm sharing with you a quick start guide, all right? So you have audited your time, you've audited your tasks, you've analyzed what everybody does, you've balanced the team. So these are some critical tasks that every small business owner should have in their organization, all right? I know I'm talking to SMEs, I'm an SME, so I'm sharing with you things that I do and things that I use to support tasks and activities that I support my paying clients also. So there are many system directories, but these 4 activities of an enterprise as outlined on the left should be for any organization. You need to have a system for attracting clients. You need to have a system for converting clients. You need to have a system for delivering the clients and collecting your cash, all right? So ACDC, if you remember nothing else. So in attraction, that is what we call marketing. I don't know why they say sales and marketing. In my opinion, they should say marketing and sales. Anyway, so how will you attract clients? And why are you attracting clients? What is your value proposition? How do you create value for the company and for yourself? I often tell people in my sessions that if there's no cash, it means there's no clients. If there's no clients, there's no cash. And if there's no clients, it means you have a weak value proposition. And that is something that can be corrected. A good value proposition will create value for you, the business owner, the customer, and the company. That means everybody gets paid. Because most of our businesses are creating value for the customer and not for ourselves. We need to change that. But anyway, today we are doing business process automation. So in the ATTRACT system and in my talk, system stands for a step-by-step process that brings about the same result. So when I say your attraction system, it could be automated, it could be manual, but you need to have a way to attract clients consistently to your business. One of those ways is your website. People like social media, and indeed we need to use social media. But imagine tomorrow you wake up and your Facebook has been hacked. Those followers are gone bye-bye. However, on your website, if you have, you can have a way that every time somebody lands on your website, they have an offering that makes them leave their phone number, their email. So you have their contacts. You can nurture that. You can nurture them with email marketing, and all this can be automated. And you can have every month, you can have something on your website, a different topic, a different theme, all right? Would you like to turn your passion into profit? Click here for 5 tips to turn your passion into profit. When they click there, they put their name, their phone number, and then the first email goes to them. Thank you for expressing interest on how to turn your passion into profit. Here is your first tip. Look out for the next 4 tips. All this is automated. You don't have to sit and, you know, type an email every day. What are you doing? You are attracting customers. Your website needs to have SEO, search engine optimization. So that is automation working for you, helping you to know who are the kinds of people that are visiting your website. And then you can use a Pexel or something like that, because that's not me, but there's something you can put. You can mirror that on Facebook so that when you do paid advertising, you attract the same people. That is what automation can do for you so that you're not spending a lot of money on flyers and kanjo. So that's number one, your attract system. You can automate your attract system, but there are other factors that go into the attraction system. The next thing is, how do you convert, all right? So once they come to your website, they get an offering, and an offering is not something for free. An offering is something valuable that you can give for free. For free doesn't mean it is not of value. Like if I give you 5 tips to turn your passion into profit, you want to do that, that is valuable, but I can give it to you for free. And then what else? And then now you'll have their phone number, you'll have their email, then the sales team can get on. The sales team can now make calls. And when this, or you can send out a bulk SMS, but when you call, you'll be calling a real person, all right? Then the next thing is the delivery part. What are some parts that you can automate in the delivery system? The shipping. And this is for those people that have started. We all work from home now. And working from home is a great convenience for me. You can shop from home. During COVID, we started shopping from home. I personally shop at Chandarana on my WhatsApp. So I can shop when I'm in a meeting. Before I get into a meeting, I send my shopping list. By the time I finish my meeting, I get the deal number, I pay. What is that? That is shipping, the last mile delivery. Many people have started businesses during the pandemic and are using chatbots for the last mile part of their process, but they're not paying attention. I have a wonderful person who makes chapati for me. And every time you go to her WhatsApp, it tells you, we are not here, we'll get back to you as soon as possible. And then you put in the WhatsApp, I'd like chapati on Tuesday. She won't respond until Thursday. And on Thursday when she comes, you cannot get chapati until you pay. I make the payment. The next thing you come, They still know chapati, and now she's sending your money back because they are not working. So remember, I said that if you're inefficient before automation, your inefficiency will just be amplified when you automate. And remember, clients are using digitized tasks and digitized tools because they want convenience, they want speed. So if you don't do things quickly, they're going to walk away. All right, so I'm not going to wait for my chapati for 3-4 days. I want to eat chapati today. You are not there. You'll come back as soon as possible. You'll come back on Thursday. How many chapati cookers are out there or chapati chefs? I'll move on. So that is the one downside of automation and digitization, because it has opened up the pool of suppliers. So we need to be more conscious of our customer service. So yes, it is easy and less work on us as the suppliers, but the customer wants convenience, the customer wants speed, and the customer wants consistency. So these are things that we need to consider when we are automating so that we amplify our brands and increase our customers. Alrighty. So we're getting ready to. So finally, we have, so in the delivery part of the process, you have the shipping part, you have the admin part. Admin, like the person who, when somebody fills a form or talks on your WhatsApp, who is going to be checking? Like all the forms that, you know, we have people registering on, come to me for an organization that I serve in, come to me, and then also go to the executive director so that we can see who are the people who have signed up for the different programs. And once we know who have signed up for the different programs, that data gives us information to make informed decisions, all right? So the admin part is critical. These automated tasks, these automated items, who is on the back and which human being is ensuring that what needs to happen is happening and that the people signing up are not being ignored. So that goes in with that. So the admin part, and then there's reporting so that you can, this data should give you insights of how to grow, how to make changes, how to shrink, okay? What to transfer, what to stop. And then finally, analysis, that's the analysis, okay? So the delivery part, how will the service go out? And then how will the process be managed end to end? And then what will the reporting look like? And I like a simple form, like a Google form for registration. When somebody registers, you get an email letting you know that somebody has registered. You can reply, you can automate the reply. Thank you for expressing an interest on whatever. So they know something has happened. All right. And then at the end of the week, you can look on the back of that form. There'll be a Google sheet and you can see who signed up at what time and what they wanted. So you can analyze that information to give you information to make decisions. Finally, the collection. All right. This is the part we all like. How will you collect your money? How will you collect your money? Of course, we have M-Pesa. We have all kinds of things. We have iPay. We have PesaPal. And I think Open World also does. Open World is here. She's going to be letting you know how you can use their system. And I like Open World because I think it helps you collect money, but it also helps you to manage money. Because we need a tool not just to collect money, thank God for M-Pesa, yay, but we also need something that will help us track our money and budget our money. So a tool that does that is excellent. I know PesaPal does that. I know iPay does that. And we are going to hear what Open World does. So stay tuned. I'm almost finishing my part, and then I'll be welcoming Open World, Twiva, and StockUp to share some practical resources that you can now put to use. All right. So accounting, you can have a POS point of sale that can help you collect money and manage money. There's Wave, there's QuickBooks. Let me go to the screen with the different tools. I hope you get the systems. At the bare minimum, for a small business owner, you need to have a system that will attract and convert clients and deliver and collect your money. So when you're doing your time and task analysis, you want to pay attention to how the tasks are done in these four areas, because these are the engine of your business. And on marketing tools, my favorite ones are Buffer. buffer for scheduling social media because our social media manager can schedule, I can approve before they go out, all right? So I can be a micromanager. So automation helps me to micromanage. So it doesn't have to come to my email, she'll get the work done. I can approve it before it goes. MailChimp, I love MailChimp because it sends automated emails. It also, you can also create a landing page for different offers. So somebody can see the landing page and then click to register or whatever call to action you have. CRM, client relationship management. HubSpot is a good one. Infusionsoft is the Mercedes of them. And then there's Zoho. Zoho did quite work for me. So in CRM, I recommend HubSpot, but I believe OpenWorld has. All right, so I'm really looking forward to the next session to hear what OpenWorld has, because I believe they do all these things and they're right here. So we need to promote Kenya. So stay tuned to hear all that. Delivery, Sendy, Glovo, Bolt, Uber, all right? Private courier, whichever one you have. I like Bolt. I'm surprised I didn't put Bolt there. Finance, I like Wave. There's a client of mine that is persuading me to use Sage. It's a bit of a Mercedes, so I'm still on Wave, which is the free version if you have an American address. Communication, WhatsApp. WhatsApp has been good for team management. We are being introduced to something called ClickUp. I haven't put it there because I haven't used it, but actually it's down here, project management, ClickUp. If there's anybody who has used ClickUp, I'd like to hear more about it. Collaboration, of course, Google Drive and OneDrive. I love Google Drive better than OneDrive. Please don't tell them. I have both, but I use Google Drive more. And then scheduling, there's Calendly and there are other calendars out there. I like Calendly because it's free. I'm an SME, so I manage my finances. And then meetings, my favorite one, of course, is Zoom. Zoho works. Google Meet kicks me out every time. I don't like Teams because I don't share appropriately. I love Zoom. And another favorite tool of mine for performance management is Best Year Yet. That is what we use to coach our clients to help them manage their time and their tasks so that they can produce the results that matter to them. Okay. So with that, I'm going to end my session here. My promise to you was to share with you a quick start guide on business process automation. I shared with you the definition, some benefits, what you're to automate. I gave you a 7-step quick start guide, and then I showed you how to balance your team. How to balance your team, when a team player is not performing, it's normally because they're not in the right place. So have conversations with them. What do they love? What is working? What is not working? And see how you can help them to produce the results that you want. I shared the sample systems directory, and I'm now going to hand it over to James as we hear more about the resources that we are in the house. And I leave you with this one quote. What stands in the way often becomes the way. What stood in the way for me in managing my calendar is what opened the way for me to have Calendly. So don't get irritated. Don't tolerate what is not working. Ask questions, be curious, and find something that can work for you.
Thank you, Frida, for that insightful presentation. So we are going to have a presentation from three platforms that we work with at Ajira Digital Program. They are going to share their solutions on how they can support your business in terms of automation. And at this juncture, I want to welcome our first presenter, who is Ken Getonga, who works with the StockUp. We'll have another 10 minutes to share about their solution. Then we shall hear another solution from our other presenters.
So StockUp is more of like a fintech solution that helps you to digitize your business. And to do that, we are providing several tools, including number one, inventory management. We are trying to help you know about anything related to your inventory. Then we have the point of sale part, whereby you're able to see how you make sales, how cash come in and all that. And then we have cash flow, how money is moving in and out. I'm sure she mentioned something like that. And then we also have data analysis. So this is a field we're trying to really capitalize on to ensure that in this modern world, it's not just about you making sales going now out of the 10,000, how much came in as cash, how much was on mobile money, how much was on credit, how much was from cash and stuff. So apart from that one, which is the best-selling item. So all this you're able to do just from the app. So the app, we have these two parts. We have the store attendant and the store owner. So it was designed this way to ensure that in case you have an employee, I'm sure most of us, we are Kenyan. So we are very known for hustling. So I'm employed somewhere, but I have like a small boutique running somewhere in town. So in case you have an employee, you're able to set them up. And then whatever they'll be doing on their end, you're able to get that in real time. So we have the store attendant and the store owner. I'll show both. And let me start with the store owner. So once you create an account like any other system, this is the page that you'll get. So this is the store owner. So the app has been divided into seven major features. So we have stock setup, where you set up your stocks. We have stock in manager. This is where you manage your stock in. That is stocks coming in, or rather what you call purchases. We have the sales manager's part, where you manage anything related to sales. We have profit and expenses manager for expenses and knowing some of your analysis. We have the cash flow manager. We have my attendance, and lastly, we have usage manager. So under stock setup, this is where you set up your stocks for the very first time. So you start by adding an item, a picture of the item, you know, the name of the item. So let's say this is a boutique. So I have these khaki shorts. I have 20 of them, one buying at 20 shillings, selling at 25 shillings. So I'm able to add it here. And then I'm able to see all my items now in this particular part. So I mentioned about analysis. So we are very keen on that one. So in this particular part, you're able to see that the app is showing you the stock value you have, the estimated profit should you decide to sell everything in your store. So we're able to get that one from here. And when you go a little bit deeper to any particular item, so let's check the year 2021. I'm sure that's when we had a whole year. So this is what I'm saying. So the app is able to show you that this item called AfricanWear 001, for example, you know, for the last 12 months, that is the whole year of 2021, how was that single item selling? What's the profit of this particular item? Because we just don't want you to make sales. We want to tell you more about that. Then we have count, whereby you're able to do stock taking for your item easily with the application. And lastly here, you are able as well to generate the report. So are you looking for all the items? Do you want to generate barcodes, for example? We have businesses that they want to scan barcodes. So you're able to do that one. The app actually can help you generate barcodes, or if you deal with products that have barcodes, you are easily scan the barcode just using your phone. So that's about stock setup, anything related to setting up the stocks. And then we have stocking manager. This is where you're able to add every time you buy new items. You're able to add now the restocking, basically. You're able to add it here easily. You're able to pull the reports for whichever period you want to view the reports for. You're able to do that one. And as well, you can pull the report on my top right corner. That's where we have all our reports. That is either in PDF or in Excel. So apart from that one, you're able to see the suppliers. I'm sure there's so many businesses whereby they check items on credit and then they pay at a later date. So in case that's exactly what you do in your business, don't need to worry. The app will be able to capture and to have all their suppliers on credit. And every time you make a payment to any supplier, you're able to see how you've been paying that supplier, you know, for the purposes of records. So we all have this under stocking manager. And apart from that one, we have the sales manager. I'm a bit fast because of time. So under sales manager, as I mentioned, this is where you're able to make sales. You're able to view the sales for the day, for the week, for the month. And as I mentioned about the data analysis, we are trying to give you, I think I've mentioned that. So like this shop made sales worth 500,000. See, we just don't want you to know that you made sales worth 500,000. We're telling you now, broken down for each day, which day you made the highest sales, yeah? Which are the first and the selling items, so that you know these are the items that are really selling in my shop. Then apart from that one, we have what you call the payments modes analysis. I'm sure Frida mentioned something to do with people paying with M-Pesa, other paying cash, you know. So the system is able to break down that for you. And also we are able to show you compared to the previous month, where are you exactly? So like this is the month of March. So compared to February, in terms of sales, where are you exactly? So are you really going up? Are you going down? So like in this case, this is 20% less compared to last month. And then we as well have the customers manager here. So this is where, just like the suppliers, you're able to capture all your customers on credit. So in case you issue items on credit and then they pay at a later date, you're able to capture this one. And then here we've introduced what you call the wallet. So there are those businesses whereby a customer deposits the money and then to take an item in the future. So you're able to capture those deposits. Apart from that one, while still here, if you slide from my left to right, you're able to see a call, text, and WhatsApp icon for that particular customer. So while using StockUp, you can actually call your customer, you can text your customer, and you can actually WhatsApp your customer easily from there. Then you have the bulk SMS. So should you want to send a bulk SMS, like right now, Easter is coming, yeah? So you might want to wish all your customers a happy Easter, or maybe you have some offers for Easter. You can easily do that one just from the application. Then we have Profit and Expenses Manager. This is where you're able to see now the profits or the analysis of your business in terms of profits and expenses. So I'm able to see now for the whole year 2021, how much I spent on airtime, how much went to delivery cost, internet, and the rest. And then we've also tried to break it down. Remember, we are very keen on that, on details, on data. So like for the whole 1 year, you know, your expenses, which month had the highest expense? Maybe it was October in this case. Why was it exactly October? Maybe that's when we were reopening the business. And then we are trying to tell you now, apart from showing you all the categories of expenses, now which category of a specific expense is really taking, you know, the huge chunk of the amount. So in this case, maybe it's wages. Are you really having so many employees? Do you want to reduce them? And then maybe in case you have several people using the system, you're able to know who entered what. So you're able to get this just from the just from the application. And then we have this particular part about knowing the profits. So the app is able to, based on the sales that you've entered, now accountants in the house, we have the gross profit, the bad stock, these are items that are expired, missing, blah, blah, blah. You're able to have all of them. The VAT, she mentioned about that. So you're able to have all this easily from the application. Then we have Cash Flow Manager. This is where you're able to see how money comes in and out of your business. When you make sales, the money comes in, so you're able to capture this one easily. And then second last, we have My Attendance. So this is where you're able to manage now the employees or the attendance that you have. So for any specific employee, you can set the roles that you want them to do. Maybe you want them only to make sales. So you're able to do that one easily. Now, again, apart from that one, we have what you call the lock time. So the app is designed in such a way that you can set at what time do you want the app on the employee or the attendant side to open or to close. So you're able to see it, to set that one. You can as well see the logs. So the logs, these are the things that they put, delete, edit, and stuff. So you're able to capture that as well. And also we have the data bundle monitor. So in case the employee is given 20 MBs and after 2 days an assemination, it's easy for you to know what exactly did what was the exact bundle used by StockUp for that particular period. So as well, we have the attendant performance analysis. So for those of us who might want to know, I have 4 employees, how are they performing? So we can always pull that record here. So in form of a graph, it's well analyzed and you're able to get that one. And then apart from that one, we have the last part, what you call the usage manager. So the app is free to download, to install. We have 0 setup cost. And then after that one, we have 7 days for trial. And then past that one now, these are the rates that we charge. 500 shillings for 1 month, 1350 for 3 months, 2650 for 6 months, and 5,000 for 12 months. And actually you can use for free if you invite your friends. So payments, it's just done exactly from the application. So that's about all the features of the app in a nutshell. You're able to manage multiple stores. So that is another advantage that you have. So one application, you can manage all your stuff across the country. So in short, that's the app that we are having. And it's such interesting to have it. It's Kenyan, owned by Kenyans for Kenyans. And we are grateful for this show. Thank you. Thank you, James.
Again, good morning. My name is Peter Kironji. I'm the founder and CEO of Twiva, which is an influencer marketing and social commerce platform. And we help businesses, particularly so, MSMEs, to market and sell their goods and services through social media influencers. I'll start by discussing what Twiva is and the problem we solve. Then we can discuss solution and look at how you can leverage this tool to automate some of the business's processes and how you can capture value out of that. Preferably, we always like to start by looking at why we exist at Twiva and as Twiva. And that is the problem that we are trying to solve. I'm sure we all agree that one of the main challenges that we all face, and particularly so as SMEs, it is the lack of access to markets. 70% of merchants don't have the necessary digital skill set to market and sell online, and particularly so to perform well. We are doing it, but it can be optimized. And then, of course, there is the lack of trust for folks who are engaging with our businesses online. And this is more skewed to the commerce when you are trying to transact with consumers online and they need to process their payment. They need to trust that if they buy something, they'll not only get it, but they'll get the quality that was presented. So those are some of the challenges. So what you have today is that, yes, you have millions of consumers that you can reach online, but there's that barrier in terms of having low trust, the skill set to position these products and services online so that they can be successful. And of course, there are options or alternatives, but they are quite complicated. That doesn't help the bottom line for us. So what we are trying to solve is, how do we solve the challenge that businesses have by the fact that they lack affordable, efficient, and sophisticated access to market? Our solution is quite simple, doesn't do everything, but we do one thing and do it right, which is to give you the vehicle to reach consumers online. Ours is an influencer-powered social commerce platform. Through this, we're able to solve the trust bit. Folks tend to trust influencers. And when I say influencer, it's not the stereotype influencer that the industry classifies, which is people with thousands or hundreds of thousands of followers. To us, an influencer is someone who is influential enough to convince you to package information in insightful manner, and preferably so someone who can convert, can make at least one sale. So what we have seen on our platform is that there are folks who have south of 1,000 followers, but they're actually performing the celebrity influencers. So that is what we call an influencer to us. And these are the resellers on the platform. So our solution is to help you market and sell product and services through a distributed network of social media influencers. Again, they tend to have the digital marketing skill set. We all agree that they are good content creators. So they know how to position products within that ecosystem. It is social media for success. And again, there's the automation bit. How do you list your product across all social media platforms as to gain access to consumers who nowadays are spending more time on these platforms? Briefly, so on the solution, how does it work? And actually, does it work? It's a very simplified process. You just list the products or campaign briefs, depending on what you want to do. Maybe you have a product that you want to sell, or you want maybe to launch a product, business, or want to market. That's the campaign brief. Then Estuiva would be matching those products or brief with influencers, strategic influencers that would help you market and sell your goods and services. Then influencers would share these to their social media audiences, and we are automating that to make it more simplified and efficient for you. And of course, once the influencers are pushing the content or the products or the services, then that traffic is directed to your business. Influencers would be earning a marketing fee and a commission out of every successful transaction that they make for you. The problem within the industry today is that people are paying influencers to attempt to create value for your business, and that shouldn't be happening. What we are doing is to flip that. You only compensate them, or they capture value having created some for you. And the way we do that is to go with a commission-based business model, so that you're not paying and wasting your resources. You're only paying for the value that has been created for your business. So as a business, it's just a simplified process. Again, a one screen task, which is to list your product. What is the title of the product? The category? Are you in fashion, beauty, or electronics? Of course, the pricing point, pictures of the product. And then once you list a product, it would be exposed to all the influencers on the platform who are the resellers. They would select what aligns with their brand, the content that they create, or what they're interested in selling. Once they add that to their shop that exists on Twiva, we automate everything else. And that is us taking that one product listing and pushing it across all social media accounts that the influencer has a presence on. And then that becomes a distributed network. Folks would discover, customers would discover these products or marketing content on social media platform. And we're doing this across all social media platforms. So to demonstrate the power of the platform, if we are to list a product today, one product, and then I'd say 1,000 influencers want to market or to sell that product. And each influencer has an average of 3 social media accounts. That is to say that without incurring a single shilling or setting up an e-commerce website, your product would be listed across 3,000 online shops without spending a single shilling on marketing or creating the infrastructure. So there are 3 layers. There's the product that is pushed. There's also shoppable content. As creators or influencers are pushing any content which they do on a daily basis, they are tagging your products and that then have a lifetime online. And folks will always discover that content. They are consuming it and there is an easy way to get back to the checkout process and buy your products and services. And of course, the third one is the live stream selling, which they are doing proactively by going live and doing this. So that would be it for Twiva. Have some good news for the attendees. We are in collaboration and in partnership with KEPS and MasterCard Foundation. We'll be working with 300 businesses for 3 months, giving them subsidized influencer marketing services. And so if you can sign up today or down the line over the course of the next 1 week, we are in a position to give you some bits of it, free influencer marketing for 3 months. But of course, that's a discussion in terms of the businesses we would prefer to work with. But I invite you to take advantage of that partnership by MasterCard Foundation, KEPSA through Agila and Twiva. Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure. And I look forward to engaging you further. Thank you.
So thank you very much, fellow presenters. And thank you very much, James, for this. My name is Dorcas Muthoni. And I know Frida mentioned many times Open World, which is a company that I serve in. But I'm here to represent another business, which is part of Open World, which is called Open Business Africa. Open Business Africa is a retail trade platform that helps businesses digitize across their operations and across the things that we have identified to be quite tedious and happen on a day-to-day basis. So what we do is we help merchants through a very mobile-first approach, recognizing that most people are on the go and they just want to be in touch with their business throughout. But we also complement this with things that, hardware and tools that make, our goal is to ensure that business owners have control and freedom of their business. Because I think this is one of the biggest challenges that traders face. You start a business, you want the freedom, you probably quit your job so that you could have more time, but then you realize that this thing takes over your life. And why is this happening? It's happening because you have to be on top of things. And our goal is to ensure that technology comes in and plays into those roles across the various things that you touch on.
My name is Jane Omaitha Kariuki. I run a business of importing jewelry. It is a family business. My shop is Comet Ventures. Our shop is located along Accra Road, Junction Trade Center. We specialize in importing displays, mesh wire, hooks, the display for the earrings, the bracelet and the chains.
We also import Zupin earrings, known for good quality, good for babies, mothers. We also have a lot of official earrings, fancy earrings for the youths, and it's known for quality, very good quality, and that is what we import.
Before we started using the open business, I had some fears to use the open business initially, but now I'm very comfortable. We had a challenge of learning the inventory, the stock. It was not easy. But now we are able to access the shop when I'm still wherever I am. I'm able to know the cash in the box, how much they are selling, because all the transactions are recorded in the open business. When we were starting this, we had to come when there are no activities, so we came on Sunday. We took all the stock and we are able to feed. They did it for me, which I really appreciated. Initially, it was a challenge, but the staffs from Open Business are very supportive. I could call them every evening to come and help me to do the balancing. of the cash flow in the day, and they could turn up very fast. So it was easy for me to learn how to do the balancing, the inventory, adding a new product, and all that. When I receive a new consignment, I do the inventory, I add the inventory, so you're able to control even 2-3 shops using your phone. I control everything, but I cannot sell using my phone. They have a selling device, so they cannot access the previous details of the business. The point of sale device is used by my cashiers in the shop, which can issue a receipt, so we don't do manual work any longer. It has been very, very, very helpful to our business because we are able to see the cash flow, the transaction, and so it becomes easier for me even to know the balancing of the day. Whether I've not reported that the work or not, I'm able to learn it from wherever I am. I would really encourage the business people around, even out of Nairobi, to use the open business as a selling point. It is very, very helpful.
I didn't want to say it myself. I found it prudent to help you hear what we do from one of our customers. So that's a customer testimonial. So this customer is able to manage their stock. They're able to manage their cash box. I think this is the only app that I know where if you want to know how much cash you should find in your cash box when you arrive in your business, you could actually go there and ask and demand for that cash, because you are really on top of your game in terms of what's going on in their business, whether you're in or out. This is the kind of freedom and control we deliver to business owners. And I want to thank Kepsa and Ajira so much, because we've partnered with them to ensure that we can serve customers anywhere in the country by working through our field services platform that allow us to deploy resources on the go through an innovative on-demand approach for this kind of resources. So thank you very much for the opportunity, and feel free to engage us and ask us, and we can refer you to customers and our platform to be able to see exactly how we help these businesses as traders to solve their day-to-day problems so that they can be able to coexist with control and freedom in these businesses. So thank you very much.